In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If your vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
All writers are prone to becoming so attached to our characters and stories that we struggle to see why a passage may not be working. It takes another set of eyes to help us nurture our writing into full maturity. At Black Wolf Editorial Services, we strive to enable writers to develop and grow, shaping stories into masterpieces that can stand the test of time. Editing services are provided for all genres and all age categories. Services range from critiques of the short story through to the line edits of the full-length novel and copy editing for those preparing for publication. We also offer assistance on generating a writer's bio for your websites, as well as help with those book blurbs and promotional material. We won't abandon you to the masses. We want to celebrate with you and your successes. Black Wolf Editorial Services. Nurturing your writing into maturity. For a full list of services and prices, visit us at blackwolfeditorial.com.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-610-9050. That's 800-610-9050. 800-610-9050.
KLRN Radio has advertising rates available. We have rates to fit almost any budget. Contact us at advertising@klrnradio.com.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 $3 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Is debt beating you down? You need discipline. You need the Debt Ninja. If you've been caught in a financial trap and need to be set free, then you need the Debt Ninja. Want to stop those harassing collection calls? Start saving thousands in interest and fees and get out of debt fast? Then you need to call the Debt Ninja. The Debt Ninja will find the best companies across the country that will help you consolidate all your bills into one easy payment, reduce your payments by 30 to 50%, and get you out of debt fast. If you have unsecured debt of $10,000 or more, such as credit cards, loans, or medical bills, call the Debt Ninja for a free 15-minute consultation.
Call 800-826-1246. 800-826-1246. That's 800-826-1246. Call today.
The Debt Ninja.
It's time to hear the truth about America's biggest challenges. You're listening to America Off the Rails with your host, Rick Robinson.
Listen, folks, I'm here to tell you our political system is broken. The two-party system is dead. They have become one and the same.
Keep on doing what you do, Rick. You're my favorite host.
Favorite host.
This is always the killer, the one that just destroys that never Trump argument. Hillary Clinton will fill the Supreme Court with liberals. She'll also appoint federal judges with a liberal bent to them.
I don't feel no ways tired. I come too far from where I started from.
Don't let anybody tell you that it's corporations and businesses that create jobs.
Arrogant, sanctimonious, self-righteous, sabotaging Trump.
Everybody's got to be covered. This is an un-Republican thing for me to say, because a lot of times they say, no, the lower 25%, they can't afford. I am going to take care of everybody. I don't care if it costs me votes or not. Everybody's going to be taken care of much better than they're taken care of now. The government's going to pay for it, but we're going to save so much money on the other side.
ISIS is honoring President Obama. He is the founder of ISIS. He's the founder of ISIS.
Written by a nice reporter. Now the poor guy, you got to see this guy. Oh, I don't know what I said. I don't remember. He's going like, I don't remember. Maybe that's what I said.
What realized is that the Bill Kristols of the world, the never Trump people, they were just never serious. They never had any kind of ground game. They never had an actual candidate they could pick.
And in a surprising and disturbing move today, the Libertarian vice presidential candidate just agreed that rifles are weapons of mass destruction, and people on the terror watch list should not be allowed to purchase guns. So in other words, the party of freedom is liberty for me, but not for thee.
Compromise where you can. Where you can't, don't. Even if everyone is telling you that something wrong is something right, even if the whole world is telling you to move, it is your duty to plant yourself like a tree.
All right, folks. Well, happy Monday evening. I hope you've adjusted to the time change. It's officially been kicking my rear end since yesterday. I actually spent most of the day yesterday passed out in my chair. The time change has been seriously kicking me in the butt, and it couldn't come at a worse time because this is about the busiest time of year, especially every 4 years if you happen to do talk radio, because as we all know, this is the night before the election. So because of that, because at this point I'm sure we've all made up our minds, we're going to have a little bit of fun tonight. We're going to recap some of the parodies that have been done over the last 12 months in regards to both Clinton and Mr. Trump from our very own Third Rail Ramblers. I have a poem that I've written about the night before the election. Well, poem-ish. I mean, I wrote it, so it's not great, but I'm going to do it anyway because, hey, it's my show. And, of course, before we get too much further, I want to make a couple of announcements, and then I have a really big announcement, and then something I'm going to play real quick is kind of a quick break, and then we're going to come back and get started with the show. So, without further ado, folks, I want to make sure to remind you that tomorrow, starting at 7 p.m. Eastern, we will have live, wall-to-wall, play-by-play coverage of the election a turnout. The numbers, the weeping, the gnashing of teeth, the joy, the tears, whichever way this goes, unless somebody besides these two wins, I'll probably be one of the ones weeping and gnashing teeth. I'm not going to lie. I haven't hid it from everybody. And even on our recent launch in CRN this weekend, I didn't hide it from them either. I'm actually surprised. They apparently liked me because they're going to continue to have me on for the indefinite future. So I want to thank everybody that tuned in for that over the weekend. If you did listen, Sunday's show is going to sound a little bit like this one, but it's not going to be exactly the same thing. We're going to be playing a lot of the same clips as far as the music stuff, but it's all going to kind of go in a different direction. Because, again, we are now officially the night before the election, and I figure what's a little fun between friends before I wind up in a concentration camp? Because let's face it, no matter which one of these jabronis wins, I'm probably going into a camp somewhere along with a list of a few other people. Because our show numbers have gotten phenomenal lately, so I know for a fact, actually the whole station's numbers have gotten to the point where they've gotten really solid. So I'm pretty sure that some people are listening that have probably been plotting my death, but that's okay. It's been fun. All right, so without further ado, I want to make an announcement because we actually have a new advertiser. So lately we've been bringing lots of folks on board. I'm sure you hear their ads. We have Rebel Road Tactical, that is one of our premier sponsors. We also have Richard Harden, who actually does a podcast with us and a broadcast here basically every day, who's also an author. You can find his book information on his website. There's been a commercial we've been playing about that. And we do always invite you to check out his broadcast every day, typically starting at 7 Eastern. Some of them are an hour, others are two, but they usually start around the same time. So I do encourage you to check those out as well. But our newest one, and actually one that I'm really excited about because I've been a fan for a while, I have all of their CDs thanks to a friend who you may know who helps me run this joint around here. But at the same time, as you may not know, Madison Rising has actually been going through some growing pains. Their original lead singer, Dave Bray, and they had a bit of a differing of opinion as to the future of the group, so he actually went off and started doing solo work of his own. We've had him on a couple of times. Well, now we have Jess from Jesse's POV has had Rio on this evening, who is the new lead singer, and we've actually been promoting a new acoustic version of the Star Spangled Banner for them all day today. It has not yet been released on record, but we have been given permission to play it as often as we want for the next few days, and we're going to take full advantage of that. So without further ado, here is, with the new lead singer Rio, the Star Spangled Banner performed acoustically by Madison Rising.
This is Rio of Madison Rising, and you're listening to our acoustic version of the Star Spangled Banner here on KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes in bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red there, the bombs bursting in Banner yet wave
All right, folks, we are back, and we are live right here on KLNR Radio at KLRNradio.com. I'm trying to talk so fast, I might run on my own tongue. And we do have lots and lots of stuff on tap. Again, we started off with a special rendition, acoustic version of the Star Spangled Banner by Madison Rising and the new lead singer, no one other than Rio. So I do encourage you guys, that's actually all over our Spreaker account. So if you missed it or you don't feel like backing up to listen to it again, you can go find it. We've been posting it there all day to make sure that it runs throughout the server since a lot of our stuff ties back to Spreaker. So I do encourage you to go back and listen to that as often as you want and tell your friends about it. Make sure they check it out because they are actually helping support us and helping us to bring you the content that you guys love so much. So I do always encourage you to make sure you interact with our sponsors, whether it's visiting their websites, whether it's interacting with some of the ones that we offer that actually are offering goods and services. Make sure that you take advantage of the specials that they're offering and make sure, especially if it's something as simple as just listening to music, why not? I mean, come on, that was a great song. So make sure you listen to that as much as you can. We would greatly appreciate it because it shows them that they've made a good choice by deciding to advertise with us because we believe that we have some of the best listeners out there and one of the best listening audiences there ever has been and hopefully ever will be. Because most of you are not completely insane and don't buy into one side of the ideologue or the other. So it's been interesting getting to know a lot of you. It's been really crazy this election cycle watching people that I have considered friends completely go full Breitbart, as someone just said earlier, because it's really weird. I mean, because you have people that you know that you've interacted with that you've actually come to their defense on social media when someone was attacking them or vice versa. And suddenly, all of a sudden, you're the enemy because you will not fall in line and you will not toe the party line any longer because you can't do it. Now, I understand how a lot of folks feel, and I understand the reticent Trump voters, the ones that are just like, look, he's better than Hillary. I don't necessarily agree. Actually, I will tell you up front, I don't agree. Which is why I've already made my decision who I'm voting for, and it's pretty plain and simple to me. And I've told you guys that before, so I'm not going to go through it again tonight. But there's a reason why I'm voting for who I'm voting for, because it gives an option to hopefully keep another party on our ballot here in this particular state, because Trump has my state's 7 electoral votes. Even if I wanted to push him any further, my vote wouldn't do that. But you know what really annoys me while we're kind of on the subject of voting? Because I keep hearing about all these third-party votes that are wasted. You know, because, well, your candidate doesn't have a chance to win, so there's no point in you voting for them. By that logic, should anybody vote for Trump in any state where they know he can't win, like New York or California? Because he's not going to win there. So if you take the logic of wasted third-party vote to its ultimate extreme, isn't anyone in one of the states where they know Trump is going to lose that is voting for him anyway? Isn't that a wasted vote? I'm just asking because to me, the whole argument is asinine because no one's vote is wasted. And I've said that I don't know how many times and I'm going to continue to say it. No one's vote is wasted unless they are voting for someone that they cannot support. If they are only doing it to toe party line, then that is a wasted vote. If you cannot seriously look at a candidate and say, I'm voting for this person because they stand for this, 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 and this. If you can't do that, then that is a wasted vote because you cannot, at the end of the day, justify a vote for Trump because he's simply not Hillary Clinton. And you cannot, in the reverse, justify a vote for Hillary Clinton just because she's not Donald Trump. And that is what everybody on both sides of the aisle has been screaming and trying to ram down my throat for the last 18 months. And because I will not bow to either one, I'm being ridiculed by both. And I don't care. That's the part that none of you seem to understand. Your approval is not required for me to understand who I am and what I believe. I understand that we want everyone to fit into these nice little boxes anymore, and we want everyone to be this perfect little automaton that does what the government tells them to do, goes on about their daily lives, knows just enough to make sure their bills are paid and their family's fed and they've got a nice TV, and that's all they should really care about anymore. Except that ain't me. That has never been me. It is not going to be me. And I'm not going to continue to try to be shoved as a square peg into a round hole. And I will freely admit that I sound and act like a square peg because I'm a fat guy. I'll be the first one to tell you that. But what I won't do is continue to be blasted everywhere I go because I'm refusing to not stand for principle. I understand that to those of you who look at this as the end of the world scenario, because Hillary's going to end the world. Is that not the same thing we said about Obama, and are we not still here 8 years later? Granted, we are a million times worse off than we were when it started, and I understand that because I watched a business fold. At the end of the Bush administration, beginning of the Obama administration, I lost a business. I have been working my tail end off since 2009 to build another one, and it's just now starting to get to the point where it's turning into something. And believe me, if I thought one was going to be any better for small business than the other, trust me, I would be picking one and pulling the lever, but the point is they are not. They are both big government spenders, they are both people that are only interested in shoring up their own power, and nobody seems to notice it or to care. Alright, so believe it or not, we are already 22 minutes in and we still have lots of stuff to talk about. So I'm going to quit preaching because I feel like I've done that enough over this election cycle. It's time to have a little fun. So up next, we have the Clinton-y Server, which is a song put together by none other than the Third Rail Ramblers, KLRN Radio's very own house band. And this is something they put together, I believe it was about 13, it was right around the time that the It was actually, I guess it's been about 12 months or so. But it was pretty good, and I think since the election is right around the corner, it's all still pretty cogent, especially considering Comey just decided again today that now he's a hero for the Democrats again because he decided they're not proceeding and all the Republicans are now cursing his name again. Notice I didn't join in on that flip-flop the last time because I was waiting for the other shoe to drop. But here is, without further ado, Clinton E. Server, put out by our very own Third Rail Ramblers.
The legend lives on from Chappaquiddick on down to the blue dress of intern Lewinsky. Interwebs, it's said, is secure as the head of an ambassador out in Benghazi. With a load of files, oh, 60,000 or more than the Clinton E server had emptied. The server and crew, they all proved to be screwed when the wrath of the Jared came calling. Hillary was the pride of the Democrat side, a disciple of famed Saul Alinsky. As arrogance goes, hers was deeper than most, with plenty of scandals for review. Concluding some terms with that whitewater firm, matriarch of the left, she was preening. Then later that night, the news didn't seem right. Marie Harp on TV started screeching. When Sunday shows aired, talking heads came on deck saying, folks, there ain't nothing to see out. At 7 p.m., deleted emails poured in. War room said, righties, they'll all snow yo. And into the din, Ron Fournier chimed in, saying Hillary's career was in peril. And later that night, valid denials were out of sight. Came the wreck of the Clinton E server. Does anyone know where the love of libs go when Liz Warren looks like the front runner? Historians will say Mrs. Clinton would have won the day if she just kept corruption behind her. The legend lives on from Chappaquiddick on down to the blue dress of intern Lewinsky.
interwebs it said is secure as the head of an ambassador out in Benghazi.
So again, that was Clinton E. Server, put together by our very own Third Row Ramblers. If you like that, feel free to go check it out as often as you want on SoundCloud. Just go look up JD and Stacy, and there most of the parodies that actually we play now are actually started there. Their show is currently on hiatus. We're hoping to get it back soon, but I haven't heard anything from them. So in the meantime, we have adopted the Third Row Ramblers and made them the parody band for the entire station. So it's been interesting. Now, you know, the reason we play these things, you know, because look, you have to have a little bit of fun sometimes. Especially when you dive into politics as deeply as those of us that do this, even as a part-time gig, which is kind of what this is for me now. Full-time work, part-time pay, what can I say? I'm a glutton for punishment. But, you know, the thing that I guess is important to me is how we get through it all. And I actually, before we go to break, I actually wrote a bit of a poem that I think I'm going to read, and then we'll probably take the break. And then when we come back, we've got more parody songs to play and more stuff in the news and tightening of the polls and all that fun stuff. But so, this was something I wrote today, kind of off and on when I was at the day job. 'Twas the night before elections. 'Twas the night before elections, and not a politician was stirring. Not in the Senate, neither in the House. Ensconced in their ivory towers and snug in their beds, visions of money and power danced in their heads. As Mama and I settled down in front of our TV, what did our bleary work-worn eyes but see? Political ads on every channel, and promises galore. They offered everything possible on a platter for she and me. Each candidate promised us the world on a string. They seemed to not understand that we knew one true thing. No one in power gives one darn about us. I don't care who they are or how much they put up a fuss. So on this night before the election, what can I say? Tomorrow, November the 8th, will be just another day. I will cast my vote for a candidate I support, then set about with the work that is still in store. No matter who is POTUS, the truth still remains that America is great because of the people who live here, not because of the nozzles craving power. So as this night before election gets later in hour, I remind you to have faith and remember who we are. Because November 9th, there will be lots of work to do, and it will be no easy task by far. Whether you vote Trump, Hillary, Johnson, or Stein, as long as we never give up hope, then America shall be fine. So put away the rhetoric and the fear, and remember that 2017 is a brand new year. Our battles may remain the same, but truth be told, I wouldn't have it any other way. The fight to keep America alive is where all of us who love her survive and thrive. So to all I say, God bless America and keep her safe, and bless us all who live here in the United States. A bit corny, I know, but you know, it's November, and starting to have a little bit of thought about Christmas, and at the same time, feeling a little hopeless about tomorrow, because, you know, for those of us that have fought to bring the light of truth back to the Republican Party and try to make everybody understand that we weren't the caricatures that the Democratic Party portrayed us to be, to watch so many of us that were more prominent than I fall prey to just that is disheartening, to say the least. All right, so we are going to take a really quick break, folks. When we come back, we have even more parodies. We have a bit we haven't played in a while, which was actually done by Mr. Jason DeWilkins, the man of a thousand voices. It was actually a rendition of a Trump speech put together by none other than Eric Williams of BarbedWireSatire.com. And we're just kind of recapping a lot of the election news, craziness, and the parodies that we've put together throughout the election cycle to have a little bit of fun and wind out November 7th on a high note, because who knows, November 8th, I could wind up in a FEMA camp. It's kind of a running joke between a lot of us, but some of you know what I'm talking about. All right, so on that note, we are out for a moment, folks. We are going to take a really quick break. When we come back, much more in store. Stay tuned.
Stay tuned. Things are going to get real interesting. You're listening to the Spark Radio Network.
You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
All writers are prone to becoming so attached to our characters and stories that we struggle to see why a passage may not be working. It takes another set of eyes to help us nurture our writing to full maturity. At Black Wolf Editorial Services, we strive to enable writers to develop and grow, shaping stories into masterpieces that can stand the test of time. Editing services are provided for all genres and all age categories. Services range from critiques of the short story through to the line edits of the full-length novel and copy editing for those preparing for publication. We also offer assistance on generating a writer's bio for your website, as well as help with those book blurbs and promotional material. We won't abandon you to the masses. We want to celebrate with you and your successes. Black Wolf Editorial Services. Nurturing your writing into maturity. For a full list of services and prices, visit us at blackwolfeditorial.com.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-610-9050. That's 800-610-9050. 800-610-9050.
KLRN Radio has advertising rates available. We have rates to fit almost any budget. Contact us at advertising@klrnradio.com.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
And type in Richard Harden to see and purchase his books.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps stand ready to defend the American way of life. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Nothing like figuring out you hit the wrong button there at the very end. All right, so hang on just a second here, folks. Alright, so now that the board monkey's got everything in working order again, we are back. We are live, and that was a little bit of dead air followed by a partial commercial and my mea culpa. So how you folks doing tonight so far? Getting back into the swing of doing live broadcasts here at 11 Eastern. We're going to make some changes, move things back around a little bit because the pre-recording wasn't really working out very well. And even though our numbers were really good, kind of miss doing them live. So we're going to make some changes starting officially this next week because this week's going to be kind of a mess with the election coverage and everything else. So next week, America Off the Rails moves back to its 11 p.m. Eastern time. However, we are shifting things around a little bit. We're going to be broadcasting from Sunday through Thursday at 11 p.m. Eastern on America Off the Rails. That way we can keep the Friday show Robinson and Wright without moving anything around. That also lets us move the Rhino Report back to midnight Eastern. So that way there's set programming. We don't keep having to bounce things around. For those of you who have enjoyed listening in the mornings, never fear. We will have a new replay segment in the daytime slot because I still am secretly hoping at some point to do this for a living full-time during the day. So we're going to keep that blocked off. We're actually going to call it a segment, a group segment called Robinson on the Radio, and it will feature some of the better episodes from the previous week for America Off the Rails, Jen and Rick, as well as Robinson and Wright. So if you like listening during the day, never fear, you're still going to get to do that too. All right, so enough of me prattling on and apologizing for technical issues, etc. We are going to keep on rolling with some parody music. Again, we're just going to kind of have a little bit of fun tonight, talk about some of the things that we've done over the election cycle to try to bring publicity to the craziness, and a few other things. And at this point, we are over halfway through, so we've got to get through a couple more. This is another one of my favorites. This is actually done by the lead vocalist of the Third Rail Ramblers with none other than Eric Williams of BarbedWireSatire.com. This is Super Sneak.
Super sneak, she's super sneaky, yow.
And that, folks, again, was Super Sneak, put together by one Mr. Eric Williams from BarbedWireSatire.com with the lead vocalist from the Third Rail Ramblers, and actually is one of my favorite parody songs that has been put together for this election cycle. We actually did a Hillary's server bit for a while with Eric, and we always use that as part of the opening and closing every time we started that segment. Now, as far as something that I think needs to be said, and nobody seems to quite grasp it, because everyone keeps telling me that because I'm never Trump, then it means that I'm supporting Hillary. Nothing could be further from the truth, because there are a great many of us who have been never Trump that started out as never Hillary first. And that's been part of the problem all along. We cannot simply support one because they're not the other when we view the one that you want us to support as no better than the other. And that's the part that nobody seems to want to talk about. I have been attacked for my beliefs. I have been told that I'm going to be put in an oven. I've been told that I'm going to be shoved under the bus, hung over the wall, thrown over the wall, buried under the wall. And it just continues and continues and continues. And again, even tonight, Sean Hannity, as I was getting ready to do the show, I happened to be flipping through channels and thought I'd leave it on Fox News for a second. Because, you know, I used to really like Fox News. I used to listen to Fox News quite a bit. I still had a habit of flipping between The Blaze, Fox News, CNN, and MSNBC when I was doing show prep. But most of the time, I would land on Fox News, and it would be the one that I would keep it on most of the time. I honestly have to admit I can barely stomach listening or watching Fox News anymore, because I'm being told every time I turn around that my beliefs are irrelevant, that I'm a traitor to the country, and that if Hillary wins, it's going to be my fault. I want to remind everyone who's spouting that rhetoric of one very simple thing. It is not my fault, because we told you from day one that he was a bridge too far. We told you we would not and could not support him. You told us you didn't need us, because he was going to be such a great force for change that he was going to reach out to people that had never been reached out to before, and that it was going to be a sweeping mandate. Tomorrow will tell one way or the other whether you were right or whether we were. But I tell you this, regardless of who becomes president, and much like I just said in the little poem that I wrote earlier, come November 9th, there will be plenty of work to be done. I will still be in the forefront of that work, but I am changing my focus. I am done focusing so much on the national politics. I will do it on my radio show because it's important. But what I will be doing when I'm not on the radio and when I'm not doing the other 40-hour-a-week job is working with a group called the Federalist Coalition that is actually working on putting a party together. We're actually going to have a couple of the folks on one of the shows here in the next few days. I am also going to be starting to shift a lot of my focus more to the local level. I'm going to go back to focusing on making changes within my sphere of influence. Because, look, the simple fact of the matter is if we start working on making sure that things are right at home and in our areas around us, then the rest of it will start taking care of itself. It's a bit of an epiphany that I've actually had over the last several weeks, because I keep looking at all the people that keep saying we need to put prayer back in schools, and I keep thinking that's not necessarily true. You need to make sure prayer is in your home, because if it's in your home, it doesn't need to be in school. Now, I'm not saying that children shouldn't have the ability to pray to whomever they choose in their own private time while they're in school or otherwise. That's not what I'm saying. But what I'm saying is you shouldn't need to shove prayer down anyone's throats if you're taking care of what needs to be taken care of at home. Just like all of this stuff with abortion. If you don't want your children to have abortions, then you need to teach them what you think they need to know about abortion. That is your responsibility as their parent. Quit leaving it up to the government to decide what is going to be taught or not taught in your home or in the school. Because the school is not supposed to be the end-all be-all of education. We have allowed it to become that, and we are reaping that particular decision now in full harvest. Because we are watching now as the second full generation of people that have been ensconced in national-level education are now coming to the forefront and being able to make decisions about what our future holds. And most of them are either Bernie supporters or Trump supporters, and both of which are pretty scary. And then we still have a large group that are also Hillary supporters, which again is pretty damn scary. We are watching people that do not believe that anyone else should have an opinion different than their own, because that's what they've been taught in school. opinions don't matter anymore. The only opinions that matter are the opinions of the elite. Because unless you identify with one of those opinions, then you are going to be ridiculed. Period. We talk about how much we need to stop bullying, and yet the adults on this planet bully every single day. We talk about how many things we need to change for the better, yet we will not make those changes within our own home. That is now going to be my focus. With every ounce I have, I will still fight to keep this country great. I will fight to keep this country safe, and I will fight to keep this country free. I will do it with every platform I have available, whether it's writing for one of the many places that have asked me to submit articles, whether it's on radio shows that I do here on KLR and radio, or whether it's on any of the other affiliates, or including now CRNTalk.com. I will do what I can to make sure that I leave this world better than I found it. And I will do that with every fiber of my being, because it's what I believe that we are supposed to do. So if you, like me, are tired of the fear, and you're tired of the rhetoric, and you're tired of hearing how either, no matter which one of these presidents gets into the White House, it's going to be the end of the world. Look, I don't know whether it will be or it won't be. I would give you even money at this point that either one of them could have us glowing in the dark within 6 months, because neither one of them has an ounce of common sense when it comes to the politics of the world. But I can no longer worry about that. The die has been cast. One of two things is going to happen, unless by some miracle this gets thrown into the House, and then I still don't think it's going to go the way that any of us that are hoping it's going to get thrown into the House goes. So I can't worry about anymore whether Hillary Clinton or Donald Trump is going to be president, and I urge you to do the same. Because simply put, there is work to do. No matter who wins tomorrow, we have work to do. No matter who wins tomorrow, November the 9th, we will still wake up, we will still be Americans, and we still have a responsibility to our families, our friends, our communities, and our country to do what we must to make sure that we remain safe, free, and always in pursuit of liberty. And I ask you to do those things with me. I ask you to change your focus. Quit looking so much to DC for the answers and find the answers within yourself, because they are there. You know the right answers. You know, because again, our Creator gave us these things. We were endowed with inalienable rights. Those aren't given by the country. Those aren't given by the government, and they cannot be taken away by the government, no matter how much they tell you they can. You have the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Those things, above all else, are yours, and no one can take them from you unless you let them. So no matter who is president tomorrow, always remember that America was, is, and always shall be great as long as we, as Americans, hold her up as an example of what she can be. And that is why neither Donald Trump nor Hillary Clinton will get my vote tomorrow, because neither of them hold up America as an example of what she should be. They hold her up as a perverted vision of what they think she should be. Not what she should be, what they think she should be. All right, well, believe it or not, we are already almost out of time. I waxed a little more poetic than I planned to tonight. On the way out, we've got a couple things left to play, only because this is probably going to be one of the last times I actually get to play them, because the election is over tomorrow. So this is, and again, if you are like me and not quite ready for Christmas music, this one is actually to the theme of Mr. Grinch, so you might want to turn the volume down for about 3 minutes and 23 seconds. But I encourage you to go ahead and listen anyway, because it's friggin' hilarious. And if there are any children listening, the end has been suitably radio edited, because we actually ran it over on CRN the other day.
You're a keen one, Mr. Trump. Your manners are genteel. You commit verbal malpractice when your lips, they break their seal, Mr. Trump. You're as bad as Nana with xenophobic appeal. They're quite bonkers, Mr. Trump.
Your supporters lack control. Intellectual outliers are paid for Russian trolls, Mr. Trump. Behaviorally challenged and sycophantically stupid cornholes. A serpentine one, Mr. Trump, with a beastly writing style. You have all the cogent vision of a steaming compost pile, Mr. Trump. From a constitutional perspective, I'd take the steaming compost pile. Manipulating Mr. Trump with influence you have bought. You'd steal a family's castle for an effing parking lot, Mr. Trump. You're a weedpecker thin skin of prep school blowhard, egomaniacal dross. About your daughter, Mr. Trump, you've really nasty thoughts. Amazing, even Jared didn't want to date his tot, Mr. Trump. Your mouth is a bawling crap heap, overflowing with the most pathetic assortment of rhetorical whining imaginable. Just ask Megyn Kelly from Fox. Run your jowls much, Mr. Trump. Your numbers need a bump. Your lead right now is dwindling. Your polling's in a funk, Mr. Trump. The three words that describe you best are as follows, and I quote, bitch, ass, punk.
All right, folks, and that is the end of the parodies that we put together for 2016 that I felt were worth repeating. We've had a couple of others, but I've actually misplaced some of them. One of them was actually put together by Danny C., who used to do the Family Factor. I think that one has unfortunately been deleted. I actually thought it was kind of funny. I helped write that one, but it was put together in a bit of a hurry. It was one that we put together about Jeb when he first declared his candidacy. Sadly, at this point, I'd almost prefer him to who we have, but that is a story for another day. All right, so on the way out, just like we did on the CRN episode on Sunday, we have a Trump speech that we're going to run. As much of it as I can before we have to cut to the intro. This is put together again by the barbedwiresatire.com. Mr. Eric Williams is the writer there, and Mr. Jason DeWilkins, man of a thousand voices, who used to do the According to Me radio show and still does occasionally do an According to Me podcast.
Thank you very much. Thank you. You guys are great. Thank you. Hey, shut up. Shut up, you guys. Seriously. Let's get this done, okay? Let's do this thing. I'm busy, okay? I'm really busy. I'll say this. I'm not a politician, okay? And that's probably why I'm doing so well. But I gotta say, this campaigning thing's tough. It really is. It's very busy. Listen, I'm so busy this morning. Listen to this. This morning, I had Paul Manafort take a dump for me. Yeah, I had, listen, I didn't have time. I know, it sounds crazy. Listen, and nobody poops better than me, okay? Believe me. Nobody. People come to me all the time, they say, Donald, you poop better than anybody I've ever seen. They call me the poop machine, okay? I get it, but listen, it's either that, or I miss calling into Fox and Friends every morning like I do. I don't have time. But I surround myself with good people. Paul poops better than anybody I've ever met. Good people, good poopers. That's what I do, okay? Listen, but I think I'm going to have a lot more free time. Okay, coming up soon. We got this thing in the bag. Old Lion Ted has run back to his wife, and, you know, her Goldman Sachs donor, you know, all these people. And Kasich, I mean, what's he doing? Is he back in Ohio eating pancakes? You see this guy? This guy eats worse. I've never seen anybody eat so bad. And the only thing worse than the way he eats this campaign, it was terrible. It was awful. Incredibly bad. Incredible. Listen, the polls have us up by 80 points in California. And people love us out there. They call me California Don. That's what they call me. The people kind of, they say, Donald, we love you so much. I love them too. I was thinking about owning a winery out there. I love California so much. They're great. The people are great. I love California. Great people. Great state. What about Crooked Hillary? I haven't even started on Hillary. Hillary and Bill, they got a lot of money. Okay, not as much money as me, but they have a lot of money. Why don't you just go off to an assisted living place, okay? Leave the stuff to the experts, the tough stuff. You know, let the guys who know what we're doing handle the country. You go back to being crooked and over and eating pudding or whatever you do. I don't care. It doesn't matter to me. Look, I love old people too, but frankly, you leave the tough stuff to the experts. That's what we do. We're going to make America great again. That's right. We're going to do it, okay? I don't know how, and I don't know when, and I don't know why. But listen, frankly, we're going to make America great again. This I can tell you. And after we defeat Grandma Crooked Hillary, we're going to make America so great. It's going to make you nauseous, okay? You're going to have winning cough, okay? You're going to go to the doctor and just winning. You're going to be so sick of winning, okay? You're going to be so sick of how America is now great. It's so great, you're going to be sick of it. I promise you. Believe me. But really quick, the reason why I wanted everybody here today, I want to talk to you about the Electoral College, okay? I mean, this thing is just rigged. It's awful. Have you seen this mess? Talk about a rigged system. The Democrats have got to fix it. Look at Bernie Sanders. He's doing really well. No one cares because Hillary's got the whole thing rigged. It's in her favor. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to sue the Electoral College. That's right. We're going to take the Electoral College to court, and we're going to win. We're going to win. Okay, I know a lot about college. Okay, now look, Trump University does very well. People love it. People say it's the best education they've ever gotten in their life. Frankly, nobody knows college better than me. And this college sucks. It's awful. It's terrible. That's why I'm suing them. And we're going to win lawsuits. I don't settle. We win. Listen, I know I've been rambling, okay? That's how a lot of my speeches are. I shoot from the hip, okay? I just come out and say, listen, get that guy out of here. In the third row, get him out. He's waving the flag with the snake on it. I don't even know what that is. That thing is stupid, okay? Who designed that flag? It's awful. It's terrible. I don't even get it. But get him out of here. Seriously, we don't have time for that. I gotta go. But listen, it's been great talking to you people. Thank you for coming out. I'm gonna be on TV and radio for the next 23 hours. Plus, I'd love to stay in chat. Sean Hannity wants to come, okay? And I gotta make time for him, okay? He's a good friend. You guys have been an amazing crowd, okay? Absolutely amazing. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thanks. You've been great.
Don't.
See you guys. I'm getting him. Later.
Game over, man. It's game over.